got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum. Bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium, liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate my last remark,
donate the way, no way in the arm.
What did they do just when everything looked so dark? Man, they said you got to accent. You
ain't the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative.
Don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
My wife is barren.
Barren?
Yes, doctor.
Well, do you use the word clinically?
It's the truth.
Well, I mean to say, is that a medical diagnosis? Has your wife been tested by a specialist in the field of fertility?
No.
Then how do you know she's barren?
Well, we're married almost 6 months and she's not pregnant.
You are aware that a man and a woman share responsibility for successful impregnation?
I do my part.
I said successful impregnation, not successful intercourse. Have you ever been tested?
The Army gave me enough penicillin to kill any infection in this hemisphere. I'm clean.
Tested for sperm count?
No.
You know what sperm is?
Of course, hey.
Then you won't make the mistake of thinking there's a connection between sperm count and masculinity. The nurse will show you to the bathroom. You'll get results in a few days.
Uh-huh. Well, that's not right.
Great game, Mr. DiMaggio.
I don't call striking out from the last two at-bats in the last game of the season a great game, thanks.
Neither do I. I was just being polite.
Lousy year.
I am not looking forward to your brother's wedding.
Why not?
I don't like some of his friends.
Charlie and his wife.
Well, how did you guess?
Ginny, he has to invite them. If you're gonna be miserable, why don't you just skip it?
I refuse to spend my life avoiding them. Anyways, you're gonna help me find a date to make Charlie jealous.
I think that we should test those bed springs again. See if they're still quiet.
I think that's all you think about.
Well, I think that makes two of us.
Great game, boys.
You lost.
Still a great game. You're not gonna let those sodas go to waste, are you?
You can have mine.
You know what I mean. There is a time and a place for everything. Sarah, the ribbon for your veil finally came. And here's the guest register. Hank, would you run across the street and pick up your shoes before he closes? I had them resold and I forgot to pick them up.
Sure.
I forgot the shoes on purpose so we could talk alone. We haven't had a chance, and with your parents gone, Lord rest their souls, I wanted to make sure that you were comfortable about marriage. I am. Did you want to ask me any questions? About? About a wife's marital obligations and duties. I don't think so. It's natural to be shy, but there's no need to be afraid. And after a while, it won't even seem like an obligation. This book might help. A priest talks to the new bride. I know you're not Catholic, but you could think of it as your minister's advice. And if that book doesn't answer all your questions, you can ask me. Thank you, Mrs. Metcalf.
You have rejected every guy I can think of.
Well, that's because you haven't thought of anyone good enough yet.
Okay. Somebody on Jeff's baseball team. Maybe Bob Barsick.
He's a cheapskate.
Rick DeLuca?
Oh, he's already making time with three different women.
John Hansen? No. Tom Dougherty.
He'd choose tobacco, for heaven's sake. Would you give me credit for having some standards, Linda, please?
Say, why don't you take Jeff?
Absolutely not.
Why not?
It would be humiliating for me to be seen with a date 2 years younger than me. Anyway, everybody knows he's your kid brother. I need Tyrone Power.
Oh.
Chicago.
Detroit.
Chicago.
Detroit. Greenberg's too hot for any pitcher the Cubs can field.
No.
Yes.
Oh, no, not the water heater. Quick, before it warps the floor.
Turn off the water.
I did. Oh, didn't you know it would happen right before the reception?
Oh, we can get it fixed before then.
We can get it fixed, but how are we going to pay for it?
You cancel the reception.
That's not funny.
Who's joking? This reception's costing a bundle.
Well, Sarah and I are paying for most of that.
All I'm saying is...
What are you saying, Slugger?
Maybe there's better things to spend money on. Things we need.
Oh, like a new baseball glove?
I pay my share. You act like you're the only person around here who has a job.
Jeff!
What is your beef?
Maybe somebody should tell Miss High and Mighty over here she should get a job. Except there's no job good enough for her.
That is enough!
Boy, did you wake up on the wrong side of the bed this year.
So, Linda, what lessons would you say you've learned from all of this?
None. The jobs are hard to come by.
What else?
That I would be lucky to have one.
And?
And grateful for any job I get.
And?
I don't know, Sam. I need a job. What answer are you expecting?
From you, Linda, I never know what to expect. But I can tell you what I'm looking for. I'm looking for a new attitude, a change of heart. I'm looking for someone who wants to be part of the team, someone who knows who's captain and who's not. I'm looking for a woman who's not trying to wear the pants in the office. I'm looking for someone who's learned those lessons. Have you?
Yes.
You don't seem sure.
I'm sure.
Then I do have a job for you, Linda.
These are filed alphabetically, and then they're cross-referenced according to part number.
All right. I will tell him to be called.
They're late. I cannot fathom it. After all we've done for these people, they turn. Can you explain it?
Explain what? What we do on our own time is none of their concern.
It's very much our concern. We can't trust them to run a simple errand. How can we trust them with even more important responsibilities?
I'm sure it was Gina's idea to stay. We could hardly expect them
to force her to leave town. They could hardly expect us
to load her bodily onto the bus.
They could have had the common courtesy to
notify them. Why? I don't feel any obligation to explain my actions to them.
But they are going to ask us for
some explanation.
Frankly, I can't think of one that could possibly justify their continued employment.
Gina asked to stay. It was her idea.
Was it also her idea to keep it a secret from us?
Personal question, but so long as you ask it, I feel safe in saying the answer is yes. Do you have anything special planned? Get pregnant? I think it's special, but you'd have to ask Sarah for a reference. Come on. I figured I'd let nature take its course. What if it doesn't? Well, I hadn't given it that much thought, Charlie. Your parents ever give you any advice, any secrets? Mom did say she always prayed for healthy babies. You could pray.
Cold shower.
Cold showers?
Cold showers, cold baths every morning.
But I thought...
You thought what most people think. The cold water douses the fires of passion. But I'm telling you, the experts say hot water weakens the man, saps his strength.
I do 50 push-ups before the wife and I make love, brother. Gets the blood flowing where it's supposed to be flowing. You catch my drift?
And it works?
I got two kids. Both boys. The third one in the oven.
Tea.
Tea?
It's been known in the Far East for hundreds of years.
Just tea?
How come do you think there's so many Chinese in China?
Tea.
Where else do they drink that much tea?
I mean, all I gotta do is drink tea?
Not you, the missus.
My wife drinks tea every day. She's English.
Well, then she'll be drinking English tea. That's no good. She's gotta drink Chinese tea. The Chinese know better. It's why they drink Chinese teas. How come there's so many Chinese?
Did you and Mike do anything? I mean, was it hard for you? Was it difficult? Did you have any problems?
To become pregnant?
Yeah. I mean, I hope you don't mind me asking.
I don't mind.
Did you ever have, like, a special secret your grandma passed on or something? Something.
Well, we did one thing.
What? I'm sorry I have to ask, but I have to ask.
When Mike and I made love, he would put his tie on the doorknob outside. So his friends would not disturb us. Eventually, this is not a bad idea. You do it, and I will not come in.
Thanks.
Charlie, you're home early?
I just wanted to...
I am going to the movies tonight.
Oh, what a smashing idea.
No, not us, honey. We saw this movie already, and you didn't like it.
Yeah. Go see a double feature.
You gave her money to go and see a movie, and we're staying home.
We have better things to do than see a movie. Give me 2 minutes while I finish these.
And while you're waiting, fix yourself a cup of tea. I bought a new type that I think you might like to try.
I can't work Saturday. My brother is getting married on Saturday.
I wouldn't have scheduled you if it wasn't an emergency.
Sam, my brother's wedding is my emergency. It's not as if I'm asking you to go fishing. I'll work Sunday.
The work has to be done Saturday in order to be in New York by Monday morning.
I'll come in after the reception.
The last overnight train leaves at 6.
Would you miss your brother's wedding?
If I wanted to keep my job, I would. And I resent you trying to make this personal. Listen, if it was up to me, I'd let you go.
It is up to you.
I don't make the rules. I wish you could go, but company policy is company policy. You know that as well as I do. What can I say? I'm sorry. Now, what about that new attitude we were talking about?
Sperm count, motility, everything appears normal.
So I checked out okay?
Now I'd like to see your wife.
Do you have any suggestion how I could tell her?
I never tell a man how to talk to his wife. But if she wants children as much as you do, she'll be in here before you can say examination.
I need to wear something smashing to the wedding. Do you think this is too long?
I hope you take it up. Caroline.
I don't want to look like somebody's mother.
I found this on the floor.
Must have fallen out of my purse.
Is it yours?
It's mine, and it's none of your business.
But why do you have this if you're trying to make children?
I'm trying not to, love. I'm never having children, and you never saw this. So, what do you think of the dress?
The dress is fine.
Gone. Dad.
in here. You're drinking.
I've had two sips.
But you don't drink.
That's what I told your father.
Well, now the Lord himself changed water into wine and wedding in Canaan. Now, why would he have done that unless he intended for people to have a drink now? And then...
If I have never before heard the devil quote the Bible for his own ends, I have heard it now, Abel Davis. Doesn't it sound that way to you, Robert?
What's the occasion? We are celebrating...
our disemployment.
You were fired?
Yesterday.
Why are you celebrating? A glass of wine with a beautiful woman. 'Tis better than crying in your beer.
Music would be nice. Should I turn on the radio?
Suit yourself.
I don't think my suggestion deserved that tone.
That was no tone. Suit yourself.
You've been out of sorts all day. What is the matter?
Nothing. My gray suit was not taken to the cleaners. The burned-out bulb in the hall closet was not replaced. My car has a scratch. Maybe we were hasty in firing the Davises.
Well, these things take time, but all things considered, I think the new help is working out just fine.
Fine? You call this fine? This casserole would gag a goat.
I made the casserole.
It's not the end of the world.
News to me. Can't stand missing your wedding. Sam is such a jerk. Can't understand why anybody at the office puts up with him.
Sorry. This porch is hereby off limits to all dames. Bachelor party.
Yeah, no dames, see?
Name one dame who'd even want to be out here with you guys.
So, Mud, who are you bringing to the wedding?
What, you mean a date?
What else would I mean?
Nobody.
Ooh, big mistake. Women get very sentimental at weddings.
And soused. Opportunity knocks.
If you don't have a date, you make sure you stand behind the woman who catches the bouquet.
I'm not that desperate.
Whoa. You mean to tell me you're already getting all the sex you want?
Maybe with himself. He's a virgin.
Go on, says you.
Virgin. Who is she? Whoa, whoa. Who is she?
Come on.
He's bluffing.
I'm your brother. You
He's bluffing.
Come on, I ain't got to tell you guys enough.
Because there's nothing to tell.
Says you.
The wise young bride does not expect your new husband to be an expert in the art of lovemaking and does not make comment on his inexperience. Rather, she finds joy in intimacy and contentment in providing him fulfillment, which with patience, kindness, and a reliance on faith may someday also be hers. Where did you get this?
Shh, Mrs. Metcalf.
I wonder. Oh. I don't think I can wait for my fulfillment. My husband was no good in bed. I'd throw him out. You think you look any different when you're not a virgin?
No, what?
What? I'm serious.
How can you ask a question like that?
It's a reasonable question. You can tell just by looking. Charlie's wife's no virgin. What? You can. What?
Why should I go and see a doctor?
Because you're not pregnant.
I'll go and see a doctor after I'm pregnant, won't I,
no.
Silly?
You should see a doctor because you're not pregnant. I did.
You did what?
I had my sperm counted. Doc says I got plenty.
Well, I could have told him that.
No, this is different. This is a fertilization process.
What a fancy word for what we do. Fertilization. We could tell that doctor a thing or two about fertilizing, couldn't we?
Will you go see him?
Why not? After we've tried our best. I think that's all we really need to do, Charlie. We just have to keep trying. And trying. And trying. I'd rather do that, wouldn't you, love? Than visit some silly old doc. It's more fun. And a lot less expense.
Let me make sure the door's locked.
And I'll make a quick visit to the lobby.
I knew we should have finished these last night.
There's plenty of time.
There isn't any time. Be careful with that.
The stain won't come out. In fact, it looks worse.
You never use water on rayon.
What a dummy. It's a good thing he's getting married.
Go up to my closet in the back. I saved two of your father's ties. I was going to surprise you both.
Oh, so he gets first pick.
I got married first.
Oh, I'll be thinking of you the whole time.
Quit the mushy stuff.
Shut up.
We'll save you a piece of cake.
Hi. Oh, look at that.
Oh, it's gorgeous. Yeah. Jeff, clear that. Helper. Oh, thanks for bringing it over, Ginger. Tell your mother I will pay her next week. Mm. I've got to get to Sarah's.
How much did this cost?
Well, my mother gave you a discount because you're friends. Where are you going?
I'm off to set fire to the factory. Want a date?
It's for me to know and you to find out.
Bye.
I bet my mom spent $100 on this wedding.
I think weddings are stupid.
You and me both.
Beans again. I meant to say... Beans. Again.
Have you prepared your toast?
Nobody wants to hear a corny toast.
It's expected of the best man.
Mom,
and it would mean a lot to your brother, and it would mean a lot to me. Who's that young man with Ginger?
I've never seen him before.
There's that clerk from the drugstore who's so rude to me. The one who's hanging on to that poor man. Is she a friend of the family's?
Her name is Ginger Szabo.
You know her?
I knew her.
You knew her or you know her?
Oh, I guess I still know her. I told you about her, didn't I?
I'd remember the name.
I was sort of engaged to her, in a way.
That explains a lot.
Don't get upset.
Upset? Charlie? How could I be mad at you for choosing me over her?
I don't like getting called off the golf course. I don't enjoy hearing reports of insubordination. I don't like knowing that an employee that I trusted and an employee that I've given a second chance disappeared from her job. This is not a pleasant position you put me in.
I'm sorry, Sam.
Sorry? What good does that do? Tell me what your fellow employees will think if I let this slide. Tell me.
Well, it won't happen again.
How could it happen in the first place? You forced my hand. You leave me no choice.
Well, all I can say is I promise. Wait. I'm apologizing for going to my brother's wedding?
What's that?
Sam, you have me apologizing for going to my brother's wedding.
You are apologizing, or should be, for insubordination. But it makes no never mind to me, Linda, because you're fired.
We've never been formally introduced. I'm Caroline Haley.
I'm Ginger Szabo, and this is Arnold Bullock.
Hello, Arnold.
Say, you're English, aren't you?
Yes.
I could tell you talk different.
What a clever man you are, Arnold.
Well, I don't know as I'm so clever.
You know, I was meaning to phone you, Mrs. Haley. We have a new shipment of spermicide in. You know, the kind you're so fond of using?
Oh, good. We do use lots. You know, Charlie.
Shall I have some delivered?
It's kind of you to offer, but I'll run by the shop and pick it up myself. Ta.
Linda! You got off early, so to speak.
Sis, you made it.
But I miss your reception.
Hey, Linda's
all right,
here.
Jeff. It's time.
I'd like to propose a toast.
You're here. Toast here. Yes.
To the best brother a guy could have. At least most of the time he is. And to my new sister-in-law, welcome to the family.
Here, here.
Hey, thanks.
Don't mention it. I've lost Charlie for the moment, and it looks as though you've lost Ginger.
Oh, no, she's right over.
How long have you known Ginger?
All my life, pretty much. That is, it seems like all my life.
Where did you meet?
Oh, here, in town.
She's a very lucky woman to have found you, Arnold. If I weren't married, I, might allow myself some wicked thoughts, which I won't mention. Don't play the innocent with me. I know a roving eye when I see one.
I'm laughing because I'm not really your date. I'm her cousin.
No.
I'm not supposed to let on.
Oh, you devil.
Hi.
Hi.
You look... So who's the guy?
Arnold, he's just a guy.
How are you?
Why do you care?
Ginger, I never got a chance to explain anything.
And you never will. There you are.
Caroline, this is Ginger.
Ginger and I have already introduced ourselves, haven't we? And I met even more of the family. Your cousin Arnold is a real live wire. Come on, Charlie.
See ya.
Do you want the spermicide delivered?
What?
Come on, Charlie.
He doesn't know, does he?
About what?
If there's no way in God's green earth you can get pregnant, tell him.
She's a filthy little jealous liar. She hates me because you married me.
Sure, where's your date?
Oh, no, I don't care.
I will, Mom.
I wish your father were here to tell you this.
You're gonna give me advice now?
Always be a gentleman in bed.
Yes, ma'am.
To say it, but I'm not sorry I said it either.
She got what she deserved.
She did. She did. She is so mean. But believe it or not, I felt sorry for Charlie.
Then I guess I better not say he got what he deserved.
No. No. No, he deserved better than what he got. And I know how much she's always wanted kids.
Ginger, you're too sympathetic for your own good.
You think so? Maybe, it's nice of you to say so. Thanks for hiding me. I couldn't face anybody. I think I've had enough. I've always thought of you as Linda's baby brother.
That's the story of my life.
Well, I think maybe I'm a dummy for not noticing before now.
Noticing what?
You're no baby.
Better late than never.
Thank you. Do you think of me as, is this your big sister's friend?
No. Not anymore, I don't.
Has anybody ever come up here?
My mother comes up here about once a month. She was just up here a couple days ago.
Well. Think they're doing right now?
What we're doing is my guess.
That's an awful thought.
It's their honeymoon.
I met Charlie and Caroline.
You can't spend your whole life pining over Charlie Haley.
Well, aren't you the most sympathetic man I ever met?
Ginger, don't get mad. I just meant to say that. Look, do we have to talk about this right now?
No, what did you mean to say?
Look, if somebody doesn't love you, there's nothing you can do about it. You can't wait for Charlie.
I keep hoping if he knew the truth about her.
Ginger, he's not good enough for you.
Says you.
He isn't. Anybody who treats you the way he did doesn't deserve you.
You think so?
I know so. Everybody does. You don't want a husband like that.
Guess not.
You gotta get over him. I mean, you gotta move on, because even if he came crawling back on his knees, you wouldn't want him. Because anybody who'd make the mistake he did. Plus, he'd be divorced.
Damaged goods, so to speak.
Well, exactly, and you wouldn't want a husband like that.
I don't know.
Ginger. Think more of yourself. He's a louse.
You're right. I know you're right.
You can't stop. We can't stop now.
Well, if we stop any later, it'll be too late to stop, won't it?
Why not? Why?
Could I believe everything you just told me and take this lightly?
Well, I can. You mean I just talked you out of this?
You know what I like about you, Jeff? A lot of guys would have tried to take advantage of the situation, seeing as how I'm sloppy, sentimental at weddings, especially this wedding, because it was like the one I was supposed to have, only except I didn't. And, okay, maybe I had one drink more than I should have, and... And a lot of guys would have tried to take advantage of me, and you didn't. You are sweet.
Is it true? All the time. I mean to say, every time, as long as we've been together. Why didn't you tell me?
I was afraid.
You can't be afraid of me. I love you.
You see?
Don't start crying. I'm the one who should be crying. Now, don't.
I think I will go for a walk.
This is not fair. You should have told me before we were married that you never wanted to have kids.
I didn't say never. I want children. I do.
Then why are you using that stuff?
Because I'm not ready yet.
We're married. How much more ready can you get? You grow up, you get married, and you're ready to have children.
When we can afford to. It doesn't cost anything to make babies, but after they're born...
My uncle says if you wait until you can afford it, you'll never have children.
Your uncle is an ignoramus.
Hey, I've got a job.
And we're barely getting by.
I just started.
Have you ever gone hungry? You've never missed a meal, let alone gone a day or two without food. Have you ever rummaged through dustbins for scraps? Have you ever gotten sick from rotten fruit because that's all you could find to eat? I have, Charlie. And I am not bringing another bloody baby into this bloody world. If there's half a chance, it'll have to do what I've done. So don't give me that accusing look. Why did you make me say all that? I love you, Charlie.
Ginger, I want to tell you that,
Jeff?
Yeah?
Do I look any different?
No.
How long do we have to wait till we can do it again?
I'm just reading. I can't sleep. I don't want to disturb you and Caroline.
Just sleep. You worry about Caroline?
No. She'll come around.
Caroline, she had a difficult time in the war.
You had a hard time, I guess, right?
Yes, but... what I'm saying is... it is understandable, yes. That she would feel this way, be unsure after what has happened.
You went through it? You still want to have children, right?
Yes. But I know others that do not. It makes sense to think this way, to decide no, or to not be sure like Caroline.
It doesn't make sense to me. I mean, nothing I did, nothing I went through, nothing makes sense without kids.
You are a philosopher.
That's the last damn thing I am. Pardon my French, but I'm not worried. You know what's gonna turn things around? You and your baby. Because when Caroline sees you with your baby, she's gonna want one. I'm serious. She'll see you and your baby, and she'll come around. 100% guaranteed.
I do not think Caroline will change her mind.
She will. Can you feel it move?
Sometimes.
What's it feel like? Can I? Do you mind?
Later tonight on Nightline with Ted Koppel, turmoil on Capitol Hill over the Clarence Thomas nomination, the latest on Thomas, and the charges that threaten his Supreme Court nomination.
This is Joan London.
And Charles Gibson.
Tomorrow, health information for today's woman coping with hormonal changes.
And then a look at some incredible inventions of the near future. Plus, Ken Wall on Good Morning America.